Capoeira is an Afro-Brazilian martial art, and it combines dance, acrobatics, and music. And for more on this, we turn to Ashe Capoeira Chicago Contra. I'm going to get this right. Contra-Mestre Bambu is here with us now. Good morning, Contra. Good morning. So nice to have you here.
Thank you.
So let's talk about that name, and I'm going to do this one more time. Contra-Mestre Bambu.
Correct.
It's not your actual birth name. Can you tell me the meaning of it and the significance?
Well, Contra-Mestre is my title.
Okay.
It's kind of, Mestre means master. Contra is like counter, right? So it's kind of like a master in training. So that's a title that you earn through years of training and years of work. Bambu is actually my Capoeira nickname. In Capoeira, you get a nickname that's usually based on your appearance or based on something that you look like or how you act. Bambu is bamboo, right? And
sure.
It's like basically because I was very, very skinny and I bent very well.
Huh.
So they gave me that nickname to kind of make fun of me a little bit, right? But the history of it goes back to slavery in Brazil. Capoeira is created by the slaves who used the martial art to escape their slave masters. With that, they had afterwards, the slavery was abolished, they had to hide their identities on who they were because the punishment was death for people who were practicing capoeira in Brazil after slavery was abolished.
Interesting. So much like slavery here in the States, song and hymn was a way to cope
Correct. With
that. Very interesting stuff. So it's a very powerful message with a very rich history. So I've seen capoeira, and for the viewers at home who are maybe not as enlightened on it, is it an actual fight that we're seeing? How would you explain it?
It can be. Capoeira is a game first,
mm-hmm.
but it's kind of relatable to a conversation. Like, so if we have a conversation, we can have a misunderstanding, and a misunderstanding can turn into an argument or to a fight. So the same thing can happen in capoeira, but even more so because everything is based on movement and reaction. So everything becomes a little more primal. So if somebody kicks at your face and you don't like the way they did it, you might get upset, and then all of a sudden it can turn into a fight. But it starts off as a game, dialogue between two people, and then can turn into that.
So what are people gaining from if they want to kind of go down the path of learning more about this beautiful, I kind of say ritual almost, too.
Yeah.
What would they be learning and gaining from it?
Capoeira has so many benefits. Capoeira is rich in culture, rich in history. We have to learn a language, a Portuguese language, music. We learn to play instruments, learn to sing, learn to dance, learn to do acrobatics, learn to fight, learn to do all these different things. Capoeira is one of a kind type of art form that nothing else in the world exists like it, because martial arts typically teach you how to punch and kick,
sure.
but punch and kick can't play instruments. If you can't play instruments, someone plays instruments can't necessarily fight. Someone who can fight can't necessarily dance. Capoeira has all these aspects, as well as the rich history and roots that come from Brazil.
All right, so we've talked the talk, let's walk the walk. Can we see some capoeira right now with
sure,
the team?
Sure, of course.
All right, take it away, guys.
Mm-hmm.
All right, for more information on Ashe Capoeira, make sure you head to chicago.com or check out their social media pages. Contra-Mestre Bambu, take it away.
Vou dizer minha mulher, Paraná, capoeira me venceu, Paraná. Paranaí, Paranaí, Paraná. Vou embora pra Bahia, Paraná, eu aqui não fico não, Paraná.